Hello, so this is one of the most weird quests in the game because it needs you to catch an aurora jellyfish, and for that you need to use the troll. And let's go over here and I'll show you what I mean. You have a pursuit to collect all of the samples. The glowing octopus, you can find it during the night. The firefly squid is during the day. And the aurora jellyfish is apparently during the night with the troll fishing. That's the cargo. And this is the aurora jellyfish we need. Well, as long as it's there, we can be safely assured that we'll go and deposit it. As you can see, I'm over here. And I've been doing this for about 5 minutes. It's not going to be a very slow process. You also have to install the troll net basically over one of your fishing poles, so that's going to be a little problematic. Now, let's go and deliver it. Be careful of the huge creature in the Sarlacc pit. I guess it's easier during the night because you can see its tentacles glow. As you can see, there are plenty of fish during the evening, but I think during the day it was always very few. By the way, in case you're wondering how did I figure that out, well, you cannot figure it out on your own because you have to read the encyclopedia. And guess what, I basically had to do something like this, so go like that, and then you see the outline of the aurora jellyfish and its stellar basin troll during the night. I guess you have to check the encyclopedia for some of these things. Now let me see how do I take the things out of the... I guess you can do it like this. The deeper... I don't have the equipment to catch anything deeper. Prototype parts. Huh. I guess you just take them directly out of the net, which is not such a bad thing. I guess this will have to be repaired. So now we have a new mission. Collect all of the samples. Oh, I guess we need to go to the laboratory. Abandoned research post, which is over there. We'll try to go there and see if that is the mission. Yeah, one of the weirder quests, I don't know what to say about it. Also, this is going to be one of the more dangerous areas of the game, but at least we don't have, you know, a giant fish running around trying to destroy our ship. In case you're wondering, this is how you get the glowing octopuses. Other than that, the fish you can catch over here is not very interesting, to be honest. Oh, barracudas, I don't think I captured, yeah. Well, I can assure you the barracudas will be more expensive. They look like a nice fish, well, unless they want to eat you. Savage barracuda. That has much bigger jaws than the other ones. By the time we finish the game, we'll have quite an interesting encyclopedia. What if I put them like this, I'll have more space. No, it's exactly the same amount of space as before. Well, I guess you should always have it active. As you can see, during the day, it's only few. Let's go to the laboratory. The equipment on the table. Prototype parts. Well, I guess it lets you... Okay, let me see if the generator has something. I guess we can go back to the researchers, but before we do that, let's install our other fishing pool, because this is quite annoying. You don't seem to get a lot of loot with it. And you cannot use your speed while you're using this, because look at this, speed is over there. Trawler net is over here. So I don't understand what is the purpose of the trawler net, except for, you know, maybe doing a few quests here and there. Especially during the day, because during the day will be low fish or few fish, which means you get almost nothing. Oh yeah, those barracudas are super expensive. Oh, I guess it sells everything. I guess we can keep it over there. Said we cannot put... Yeah, I guess I understand why the developers did it like that, but it's quite annoying. As for other things, well, I'm having troubles finding more cloth. If I had more cloth, I'd be able to upgrade my ship. I guess I shouldn't make any noise. What? There's nothing watching me? That's interesting. Oh, now it's awake. The lighthouse in the distance feels so peaceful. I wish I could go there and have a nice cup of hot chocolate. Yeah, the game isn't as dangerous as I thought. You just have to know what to avoid, and but sometimes you'll get hit by nonsense anyway. This should allow you to fish for abyssal stuff. Well, I guess it goes nicely. Repulsion machine. Nail fish, angler fish, giant amphipod, loose jaw. Yeah, that's not going to be very fun, is it? Well, I think I also want to repair that outpost in the north. So before we do anything else, let's get out of here, because during the night, in this area, it feels like it's very dangerous. I want to go over there to finally build that outpost. I'm not sure if it's a major quest or not. We'll have to see. Oh yeah, I forgot there are cliffs over here. Even more wood that I don't need. Regarding the money situation, I think I have farm too much. I have too much money. Huh. Yeah, so I guess that's how you catch the squids, the octopus, and maybe other things as well. I'm just searching for bolts of cloth. But the game says no. That's fish, more fish, even more fish. The ocean is filled with fishes. Okay, it's the material pile. I'm really curious what happens if you do this. It's probably a main quest because the developers are sneaky. They thought you would do this and you will waste valuable materials. That's it? Thank you. Oh, I have to return to the Great Marrow. Sure, we'll do that. I just want to search for bolts of cloth over here, because it seems like this would be the perfect area to get them. Thank you, game, but I don't think I need more money at this point. Oh yeah, perfect, exactly what I wanted. So see, you should come over here for upgrades in case you didn't come already. Also, I kind of regret investing so much of my resources, my research points into the engines, because this engine is a bit dangerous. If it is damaged or destroyed, you will have nothing else. Oh, I guess you can come to this place without any resources and you'll be perfectly fine. Okay, so yeah, you just have to come over here and collect the scrap metal and the wood from the surrounding area. It's a little house with an SOS. Oh. Weeks ago, rough seas, broadside. Yes. Little marrow, sure. He takes a lot of space for being such a scrawny little guy. I guess I'll have to come back to this area when I have a lot more room available. Sir, how do you feel about that magic teleportation? I don't care, we will use it anyway. What is here? I guess you just have to continue the main quest line and then upgrade your ship a couple of times. That's the new ghost ship. Now, I would like to go to Devil's Spine, but not yet. It was a very, very aggressive little marrow. That was such an aggressive teleport. Now let's use this as well. No, I have to catch that fish or whatever that was when I go back. I guess we'll make someone happy today. Well, that's interesting. So what does that mean? That's it, that's the whole quest I finished. Well, I guess we'll keep it on the ship over there. Other than that, we have a boot and we have the good boy sleeping over here. I'm not sure what are we supposed to do, hit the dog. I guess we'll take that with us and then let's go to a proper ship ride. I also bought all of those explosives just in case I would need them, but again, you don't seem to need much. Most of the times you barely need an item or two. Okay, let me catch a shark or two because these guys are super expensive. And they don't regenerate very fast and they're very easy to deplete, so let's just get them down. And yeah, this is how I make most of my money, just deploying lobster pots into the every major port, and when I come back I'll have a lot of stuff to collect. I usually do that off camera, so we'll do that the next time. Oh, and I needed one more metal piece, I completely forgot about the metal piece. Okay, there's 255. That's impressive. Eh, good thing I didn't throw away the last one. I would have been very angry if I did that. So, tier 3 hull upgrade. We have it, tier 3. And I guess now it will be much easier to upgrade this nonsense. Probably, yeah, of course. I really want another engine, but the engine requires... See, this is cool. Oh, I guess you have to take the builder to the small island as well. Sure, we'll do that as well. Well, I guess I'll have to first of all upgrade this stuff. And then, probably the engine compartment. Yeah, the upgrades are so cheap, you might as well get them. Wait, what's my current speed? 63, so it's the same speed. Wait, what is here? Let's leave alone the gray eel and let's go to the island and then... Yeah, I'll have to collect the materials off camera, but that's what I'm usually doing off camera. Just upgrading my ship little by little. Tempting, but no. Oh, so you get the components for this. That's actually quite nice. Because now I can research this fishing pole. Probably I should also go for the big engine, 52. As for the pots, I don't think it's worth investing a lot of money into these, because money is not a problem anymore. I guess engines will be the next thing, and the rods... I should probably put my points into that as well. So that's a lot of resources we are putting there on the table. Let's see how it is to travel all of this. Oh, he damaged my... This is embarrassing. He damaged my exact reel I needed. I guess now we can fish a little slower. Okay, we have the time. Yeah, I don't think we need to repair anything, we can just go. What kind of a shark is this one? I guess we have to do it just for science. And then we'll go over there and see what we can do in the mangrove. Sorry, I'm just going off point over here. It's another bronze whaler. I should be able to fit one more. Perfect. See, because of the ship, now I know more about my own ship. Yeah, I guess I need to farm a lot more materials off camera because I have all the money I need for the upgrades. Definitely going to play more of this because it's becoming more and more interesting, especially now because money is not a problem. Money was a huge problem in the first 4 or 5 hours of the game. What is there? No, let's leave it alone. I'll have to remember that for next time. Sir, we are being hunted. Well, I guess that's one great thing about the game. You always feel like you're in danger, even when you're near a port or a settlement. Yeah, it's the eyes. Those creepy eyes. Let's wait until it's daytime. I'm not going to search for my own demise. That's so loud. Oh yeah, the creature is not here anymore. I guess this is our moment. So it's time to fish over there in the abyssal waters. Probably this would be 300 something. Oh, not even 300, 200. Well, I guess I can go and look at... No, not the floating dock. The upgrade. So volcanic and shallow, mangrove and coastal. Abyssal. How do you do the abyssal stuff? Huh. I don't know, but we saved. So let's go over there and let's see what we need to do. Anglerfish, stoplight, loose jaw, giant amphoid, snailfish. Oh, that's a lot. I guess the Sarlacc pit is very, very deep. Oh, are you telling me I have to fish in the 1 millimeter of a second that the creature needs to wake up? Well, now I understand, and I don't like it. I guess this is why we need a big budget. Look at how expensive this would be to repair. Yeah, I assume that thing only lasts for a few hours, so after that you have to go back and restart it. I hope it's that. I hope I don't have to go and collect another one. That would be a nightmare. Okay, let's see. I guess we can make a little longer episode just because of all of the cool things we are doing now. No, the generator. So that's Hadal. Oh, I guess we just need to take the relic, not fish for abyssal stuff. Maybe, I don't know. My objective is not very clear, to be honest. Technically, this is the exact spot I need to be in. But this is all Hadal. How are you supposed to fish for it? Savage Barracuda, nice. You have to come during the night. Okay, I guess you have to use the same trick I used beforehand. So let's look at the cabin, the pursuit, the samples. And I guess you have to look over here, so it's going to be the abyssal part of the map. Rod, Stellar Basin, it doesn't say, oh, at any point. And it's... huh. I think I'm supposed to go here during the day only. Huh, that looks like a funny eel. Can I turn it off and then turn it on back? So how many hours does it last for? Sorry about this, it's super loud. Shapes in the deep, so I guess we need a Hadal to get something from here. Okay. The moon is running away from. Hey moon, come back over here. Where are you going? I guess I can install a Hadal rod if I have it unlocked. No, I don't have one. Mangrove Coastal, and this will be... oh, only that's Hadal. That's super far away from my research tree. What does the game want from you? What do you want from me, game? I don't get it. I guess I can upgrade my ship a couple of times and then it will be easier to make some... to have a lot of room for other materials. Okay, let's go one more time over there, and this time if we don't find anything else, I'll end the video and I'll have to search off camera. Because there are two spots with debris that I think I have to do. See, it's Hadal. I mean, it's the stellar basin. I don't think we can wander around. Oh, that's so loud. Okay, so I have to do this off camera. Probably it will work better off camera. I guess we can collect this. Sorry about the noise. That's annoying. That will scare all of the monsters away. Oh, a research piece, nice. I almost forgot you can fish them out. Ah, it's quiet again. And the Sarlacc pit is back to action. Okay, so I'll have to farm a lot more of camera and then we'll see each other when I have more stuff that I know about. But yeah, I wonder why the developers did it like this, so it's so hard to understand what they want. This is the main mission and those are secondary missions. I guess you need the Hadal for the relic anyway. As for the other stuff, I don't really have. I sold the bell bucket. I don't know, we'll search, we'll see next time, bye bye.